for me to be here today. Thank you for that lovely introduction. Although telling me that at 27 years old, you have watched my career for your entire life, I'm not sure it's the best way to endear yourself to me. You might be slightly better than that, but it's a real pleasure to be here today and to see so many of you here today, to see some icons of the trade union movement like Jimmy Copley there, who I have to say, fantastic to have you here with us. I'm absolutely thrilled that I can stand here as the leader of the SNP and say, without, I think, a shadow of a doubt, that we are now the party of working people in Scotland. I want to begin today with a message of support and solidarity to all those who have rallied today in London and in Glasgow, making their voice and our voice heard against austerity. We owe all of them a debt of gratitude. I have to say the message that has gone out from London and from Glasgow today in these anti-austerity marches is a simple one, but a powerful one, and it's this. Austerity is not a necessity. Austerity is a political and an ideological choice that this Tory government is making, and let us be clear, it is the wrong political and ideological choice. Stand in the general election as a voice against austerity, and let me make it clear, the SNP will continue to be that voice against austerity in Scotland, and we will, as we said we would in the election, reach out and make common cause with those elsewhere in the UK that also say enough is enough. Ordinary, working and vulnerable people in this country have paid a high enough price. It is time to end austerity. It is time to end it now. I also want to take the opportunity today to pay tribute to this organisation and to congratulate the SNP Trade Union Group on the quite remarkable growth that we have seen in this organisation since the referendum. And the Trade Union Group has gone from being an organisation just before the referendum of what, less than 1,000 members, to an organisation that is today not very far off 16,000 members. What a remarkable achievement that is. The SNP Trade Union Group today has more members than the entire Scottish Labour Party. And that regardless of which count of Scottish Labour Party membership you happen to be using. There was figures linked, of course, to the New Statesman this week that says Scottish Labour membership is now at lower than 13,000. One of the candidates for the leadership of the Scottish Labour Party said today is 15,500. Well, either way, the membership of the SNP Trade Union Group is bigger than that. And we intend that it continues to grow. But you know, the strength of this organisation and the strength of the SNP today is not an accident. And it hasn't come around easily. It is the result of hard work over a long and sustained period of time. It is the result of members of the Trade Union Group and members of the wider SNP taking, over a long period of time, principled, committed and determined stances on issues like the minimum wage, the living wage, fair work, gender equality, an end to exploitative 0 hours contracts. These are the stances we have taken over many, many years, and that is why so many working people across this country now look not to Labour, but to the SNP as the party of working people and the party of trade unionism in Scotland. And that, friends, is what we intend to build on. And we'll build on that by being the voice of working people. As First Minister, I published just a few weeks ago, the new economic strategy of the Scottish Government. And I was proud that we put at the heart of that strategy something that has long been talked about, but has all too rarely been put into practice by governments anywhere in the world. We have said explicitly that fair work, treating workers fairly, paying workers a decent wage, allowing the voice of workers to be heard more loudly in how companies are run, that all of these things are not just right in principle, although they are right in principle, they are also the way to build a stronger, more successful and more prosperous economy. That's what we put at the heart of our economic strategy. You know, I, throughout my entire political career, which as we've just heard is quite a couple of years now, throughout my entire political career, we have been told that in Scotland here is not unique, but it has been the received political wisdom that you had to choose between being on the side of social justice and fairness, or on the side of a strong, growing, prosperous economy. And the choice you made would put you on the left or the right of the political spectrum, but the point being, those two things were opposites. They were inconsistent. But what we are doing now is challenging that head on. A fair society and a strong economy are not enemies of each other. They are two sides of the same coin. We will not have a fairer... grow the wealth and create the revenues to fund that. But just as importantly, we will not have a fair and strong economy unless we have a fair society. Because we need, for the strength of our economy, we need everybody in our society to have the ability to contribute their skills and their talents. And in Scotland today, like in so many countries across the developed world, there are too many people who don't get that opportunity to contribute their skills and their talents. They're held back by poverty, by inequality, by not having the start in life that all of us should have a right to take for granted. And what I say as First Minister, as leader of this party, is that if we want to build that strong economy, then we must commit ourselves to building that fairer society. And let me tell you, that is exactly what the SNP is committed to doing. And we'll do that by arguing the case, by standing up and fighting for the things that matter, by being that voice against austerity. But we're also doing it by putting through practical policies that commitment and that principle at the heart of everything we do. I'm very proud that one of the things we've done recently is establish a fair work convention in Scotland, bringing together businesses, trade unions, the third sector and government together in a partnership to say that we've got to pull together to tackle the inequalities in our society and to build that better economy. And what will we do in practical terms to give that meaning? Well, let me tell you some of what we in the SNP are going to continue to do. Firstly, to make fair work that top priority. A decent day's pay for a decent day's work is something that we must make the norm in this country, not the exception. That's why in the election we argued for the minimum wage to rise significantly. You know, we've seen over the past number of years the minimum wage not even keep pace with the rate of inflation. That's why we said £8.70 by 2020 was something that we should commit to and aspire to. And I will continue to make that argument. But let me tell you what I will also argue for. Because I don't believe Westminster will grasp that opportunity. I don't believe a Conservative government at Westminster will make fair pay a priority. So I say this, if Westminster won't do it, it is time to take the power over setting the minimum wage out of the hands of Westminster and put it into the hands. Candidates for the Labour leadership has said in response to a question that she now was prepared to think about whether power over the minimum wage should be devolved to the Scottish Parliament. Well, let me say this, and let me say it in all sincerity to Kizzy and Dugdale. If you mean that, let's work together to achieve it. Because, hear this, the time for thinking about it is past, and the time for doing it. Economy. That's why our campaign to spread the living wage right across our country is so important. I'm the leader of a government that is an accredited living wage employer, and that is something to be proud of, and I say to the UK government today, it's time you follow suit. Employees, to everybody working in the National Health Service, we use procurement to the maximum within the law that we can to spread that through our contracts as well. We've funded and fund the Poverty Alliance to run the Living Wage Accreditation Campaign for us, and I have to say that is going incredibly well. 200 employers in Scotland already signed up as accredited living wage employers, and we set a target of 500 by early next year. So that is the commitment we make to fair pay, and it's one that runs through my government extremely strongly, and it always will. The second thing we will champion, though, is equality in the workplace. I launched a few weeks ago our new business pledge, again encouraging businesses to see themselves as part of this endeavour for a fairer society, to do it not just because it's the right thing, but because it is good for their business, good for the profitability, good for their bottom line. That's the message we're seeking to get across, and I have to give credit to many businesses across this country. They see that, they understand that, they want to be part of that. But at the heart of that business pledge is a commitment to greater employee participation. I used to be, as many of you here know, the Health Secretary. I see some faces that I used to work closely with in my time as Health Secretary here today. Health Service faces many challenges, of course it does. But one of the great things about how we run our Health Service in Scotland is firstly that it's run in the public sector and we're not privatising it, and we never will. And we should always look to do more. But that principle of involving the people who work in any organisation or any company and the decisions that affect that company is a sound one, and we should seek to build on that. And I also make no apology whatsoever, as the first woman to be privileged to hold the office of First Minister is saying, we need more women in the top decision-making. Gender-balanced cabinet. Scotland is now one of just about three countries in the developed world that has a cabinet that is gender-balanced. Now, partly that makes me despair that there are only three cabinets in the world that have gender balance, but it also makes me very proud that Scotland is one of them. But what we've achieved at cabinet level, we must now seek to achieve at every single level of our country, in every part of society. Women make up more than half of the population. There is no longer any excuse for women to be underrepresented where the big decisions are taken. So that is another commitment that we will continue to champion and fly the flag for. And thirdly and lastly, as we seek to be and continue to be that voice of working people and trade unionists in Scotland, let me tell you one other thing that you will get from the SNP, and that is opposition, determined opposition to the attempts of this Conservative government to undermine the rights of trade unions. The Tory proposal that for a trade union to get a mandate for any kind of action, you would have to have 40% of those eligible to vote is inequitous. But if you want to have a rule like that, then it can't just apply to change regions. And you know what? If that rule had been in place at the general election, David Cameron wouldn't be Prime Minister today. Now, maybe that's an argument for it. Where has David Cameron not been Prime Minister? There's 270 Tory MPs right now who wouldn't be MPs if that rule had been in place. So don't try and rig the rules for everybody else unless you're prepared to play by those rules yourselves. I don't want to see strikes in this country. I don't want to see industrial action. But the way I want to make sure we don't see that is not by taking away the rights, the hard-won and hard-fought-for rights of trade unions. The way I want to make sure we don't see strikes and industrial action is by building an approach to industrial relations that pulls us all together, that says if we want to build a better country with a strong, growing, prosperous economy and fairness at its heart, then businesses, trade unions, government, the third sector, all of us must work together in pursuit of that goal. That's what we are seeking to achieve in Scotland. And that's much better than setting government against trade unions, business against trade unions, the way the Conservatives want to do. That's my message to you today. We are one Scotland. We have so much more that unites us as a country than will ever divide us. And if we work together as government, trade unionists, the business community, everybody with an interest in making this country as successful as we know it can be, then nothing can hold us back. So let me end where I started, by paying tribute to all of you, people who are out there campaigning for the kind of things I've just been speaking about, people who are demonstrating each and every day that if you want to achieve something in this life, the best way to do it is get out there and grasp it, and where necessary, be prepared to stand up and fight for it. We in the SNP are in a privileged position. The Government of Scotland, the third biggest party in Westminster, with a trade union group, I might remind you in case I forgot to say it, is bigger than the entire Scottish Labour Party. That is a privileged position to be in. People in Scotland have put their trust in us, but it is also a position of immense responsibility. We owe it to everybody across Scotland to do everything we can to make this country everything we know it can be. That's what I intend to do as First Minister, and with all of you behind me, I know there's nothing we'll hold you back. Thank you.